A former Philippine senator slams the supposed plan of three Duterte family members to run for senator. But congressional leaders say the Dutertes have every right to run for public office. Sherian Torres reports.
The possible Senate run of former President Rodrigo Duterte and his sons, Congressman Paolo and Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte, has dominated the news cycle. Former Senator Leila De Lima, a vocal Duterte critic, however, believes this announcement of Vice President Sara Duterte is nothing but a political gimmick or a ploy to stay relevant. For De Lima, the Dutertes are part of what's wrong with Philippine politics.
With the political happenings now, you know, the unity team, now no longer DepEd secretary, and then of course the Duterte camp has been finding ways and means to really show to the people that they're still around, that they cannot just be counted out and ruled out. My initial reaction is to doubt the seriousness of that announcement.
Okay, why?
What is this? Is this just a gimmickry or some kind of, you know, pakulo lang para, and some kind of diversion?
Former Senator Antonio Trillanes IV, however, believes it's a calculated move by the Duterte family to control the narrative ahead of the 2025 midterm elections to blunt criticisms hurled against the family as politically motivated.
Tinitingnan po natin to sa iba't ibang angulo, no? Una dun sa angulo na gustong i-control ng kampo ni Duterte ang narrative by leading everyone to the election season, ano, parang pinapaaga nila yung simula ng election season, na sa ganun, itong mga ine-expect nila na mga issues against them, ay pwede nilang sabihin na plot lang or bunga ng politika.
At least one Duterte ally welcomes the possibility of three Duterte family members seeking a Senate seat. Senator Ronald De La Rosa believes these would bolster his re-election bid along with former Duterte aide Senator Christopher Go.
Kala ko kaming dalawa lang ni Senator Bunggo ay magkakaroon ng lonely campaign gagawin namin, pero kung itatakpo sila, di dadami na kami. Mas masaya yung aming campaign trail.
While a lot can happen until the official filing of candidacy, an analyst sees the potential Senate candidacy of three Duterte family members as an affront to democracy.
I'm assuming na hindi yun joke. I see it as disrespectful to our democracy, disrespectful to our election process, and quite frankly, I see it as disrespectful to voters, no? Kasi parang sinasabi nila yung ganong statement na tatlo kami ang sasabay tatakbo, so that means apat kami ngayon, posible apat kaming magkakapamilya sa gobyerno. At saka sabay-sabay, no? So in your face na sinasabi nila, kahit anong gusto namin gawin, pwede namin gawin.
Both Senate President Francis Escudero and House Speaker Martin Romualdez see nothing wrong with three Duterte family members running in 2025.
Well, it's a democratic nation that we live in, so any Filipino has the right, provided that they have the proper qualifications to seek for higher office.
For political analyst Edmund Tayaw, a successful Senate bid for the Dutertes would pose a problem for the Marcos administration.
There's no other way to see it. Apart from it being a trial balloon, it's like suggesting to the opponents that, hey, we can control of the Senate and it will be result to a lot of difficulty to you. No, the latter half of the president's term, no, may be weakened as a result of the possibility of so many Dutertes in the Senate.
Kung botohan, for example, for a particular interest or a particular national issue, hindi naman lalayo sa isa't isa yung pagboto nila. So, yung bang mga desisyon na gagawin nila, will it be representative ng mas maraming tao? O kung ano lang rin nirerepresenta ng pamilya at ng area, for example, for the Davao region?
There is a saying that during election day, a voter's pen is mightier than a sword. And a voter who is wise, according to Election Watchdog, is someone who really researches or understands the background of every candidate. For his choice, according to them, will not just affect his life, but the future of the next generations. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.